guys, it's Gordon at Avolites. I'm going to show you how to use the shape generator. I've selected my beams and I've located them just so that I can see what I'm doing. And this time I'm going to go to softkey D, which is shapes and effects. Softkey A here is the shape generator. And this is going to allow me to make a shape or an effect based on a particular attribute. So if I choose create, you will then see that I can use any number of these attributes to make an effect. If I choose pan and tilt, then you can see things like circle. Already, I have an interesting effect going on where my lights are performing a circle. On my bottom right encoder wheel, you can see that I can spread this particular shape over more than one fixture. So if I do that, it looks far more interesting. The other thing that we can do is we can say that we'd like it to cycle. So we'd like it to perform a specific amount of circles. If I say tap on softkey D to adjust beats and cycles, I can move my center encoder wheel up to 2. This is then going to perform 2 cycles and then it's going to stop. No. Shape generator pays attention to your fixture order, not your fixture layout. So you can see there, I have one fixture that was misbehaving. That's because it's not in the correct fixture order. If I choose a color effect, I can then edit a shape that I made earlier. So I can edit the programmer of circle. This then means that I can add more cycles, so you can see it's performing a number of different shapes all at the same time. If I've recorded these onto a playback, and I'd like to edit them after that, what I can do is I can press the connect button on my console and tap the blue swap button of that playback. This is going to load it back into the shape generator. So if I go to shapes and effects, shape generator, but this time I already have an effect firing from a playback. So I'm going to go to edit and you can see here I've got Q1 as circle and I've got another Q as rainbow. So if I tap on that circle one on my encoder wheels, it's given me more information as if I was recreating that shape again from scratch. If I clear and exit, because I've connected to this particular playback, it will fire all that information without me having to re-record it, which is great. Thanks for watching this video on the basics of shape generator. Feel free to tune into the next one.